Good morning. This is Christy Eggers bringing you a rewind for your Wednesday Wisdom with Tiffany. Tiffany's out today because she has no voice. So we're going to do a rewind with her mom, Carol Anton, who is Executive National Sales Director Emeritus. This was originally recorded on April the 12th, 2023, and it was a legacy call. So enjoy.
Well, hello there. It's so great to be with you. This is Executive National Sales Director Emeritus Carol Anton, proud mother of Tiffany Stout. And I'm excited to be with you million-dollar people today on this legacy week of, voices from the past, right? I was in Mary Kay for 43 years, and I've been retired for 5. Hard to believe. My goodness, where did the time go? And there were so many moments that, my gosh, how can you put 43 years of experience and memories into just 5 minutes? But I'm going to do my best. I'd like to share with you a little bit about Mary Kay herself, since this is a legacy call and a legacy week. Just some stories about Mary Kay. I remember one time we were on a top director trip in China, and gosh, those top director trips are so valuable to earn because you get moments like this. And I remember Mary Kay was not really excited about the authentic Chinese food. So what did she do? She went to McDonald's with a few of us because we weren't jazzed about the seaweed either. And that was really fun. It was just, she was so real. That was the message that I took from that moment, just to be real. And then I remember another moment. This was way early in my career when Tiffany was a baby. She was 6 months old, and I went to be a speaker. Mary Kay personally invited me to speak with her on a platform in San Francisco, California. And so we met in the airport, and, of course, I had the baby. I had somebody to take her home, so she wasn't going to the conference with us. But I had Tiffany with me, and Mary Kay said, oh, let me hold her. She just loved children, love, love, love. And so, you know, of course, I handed her to Mary Kay, and she just was, you know, oohing and aahing. And what did Tiffany do? Spit up all over Mary Kay's fox fur collar. I was mortified. And Mary Kay, no problem. She didn't ruffle her feathers. She just let it go by and go, isn't that precious? Yeah, not so much to me. But that taught me to just love every moment and not get your feathers ruffled. And then I remember when my second daughter, Lexi, had a brain tumor, and she was 2 years old, and Mary Kay took the time to call me from her home to the hospital. And, wow, that really showed me compassion. Like, what leader of a company is going to call one of their millions of people? But she did. Another time, I remember I had a Booker bait contest in my unit. And boy, I was really gutsy, I guess, because I asked Mary Kay if she would talk to all the winners. And she said yes. And so every single one of the winners, I'm going to tell you what, they were booking 40 parties, you know, each, because they all wanted to have a conference with Mary Kay. And all the winners she spoke to, literally for probably 5 minutes each, and I think there were about 12 of them. And that taught me to be available, to not just, you know, hide out, but to be available. And then I remember when I had my private appointment with Mary Kay in her office as a brand new national sales director. Yikes, I was a little nervous, but you know what? She just put me at ease right away. And she said, something, how do you stay thin? She goes, you know what? I decided I don't want to diet because the first three letters of the word diet are die. She had a sense of humor. She did. And then we had a great conversation from then. And I also remember that Mary Kay once called my hotel room because there was some scuttlebutt going on in my geographical area. And it was causing ripples and waves. And so Mary Kay called my hotel room just to see if I was okay. And that taught me to have concern for individuals. And then I remember the Maxine Sandvig story. She was a national sales director way before I was. And I remember one time she was in an event with Mary Kay, and they had just eaten dinner. And there, when they went to the event, there was this big, beautiful buffet of food. And Mary Kay said, Maxine, fill your plate, because she didn't want to be rude. These people had worked hard. And she goes, fill your plate. It doesn't matter if you're not hungry. And then they went home on the airplane together, and Maxine said, I'm pooped, and she took off her shoes. And Mary Kay said, Maxine, put your shoes back on. Somebody may know that we're Mary Kay. Image was really important to Mary Kay, and you know, I think it's up to us to carry that Mary Kay image on in this lackluster image society that we have. Why not be a standout factor? It makes people wonder what you're up to. So, you know, just do doll up a little bit more. I mean, I know you're going to think this is crazy, but why not wear nylons once in a while to or pantyhose to an event? A lot of people really and truly think, wow, she's kind of stepped it up a little. Anyway, what is your standout factor that you can take even beyond image? Because it will carry you far. Look fabulous all the time. And so these are my lessons for you today that Mary Kay taught me just in her own life, just living life. And that was, first of all, be real. Be real for people. Secondly, show love to everyone. And you know what? Don't get your feathers ruffled when things don't quite go your way. You know, sometimes we get a new consultant and the next, you know, 2 days later she dropped out. Okay, you can't control people's lives. They're in control of their own life. So don't get your feathers ruffled. And then have compassion for people because you never know what they're going through. I mean, so somebody may miss a meeting and you get all jumbled up in your head. You know what? She might have gotten in a car accident on the way. You never know. So have compassion for people. And then be available. Be available to really and truly help people to get to their goals. It speaks volumes because people really don't care how much you know until they know how much you care. And then finally, have a sense of humor. The best thing you can do is to acquire an ability to laugh at yourself because we all make mistakes. None of us are perfect. And when you can just start laughing because you're going, really? Okay, Carol, I did it again. It really relieves a lot of stress and you can move on. I hope that these next few months, the last quarter of this year, you make your mark huge to get to the finish line. I mean, why not just pull out all the stops for this seminar year and make it a year to remember? No matter where you are right now on the scoreboard, it doesn't matter because magic and miracles happen, and you could be the recipient if you really and truly use those principles that I talked about. Look fabulous, be real, don't get your feathers ruffled, have compassion, be available, and have a sense of humor. Use those principles and go out and make a difference for other people. Because I'm telling you what, you can never outgive God. And when you're out there giving and giving and giving, guess what? It comes back to you tenfold. So accept it, name it, and claim it. Put it out there. The universe is ready to give back to you. And make this quarter your best quarter in Mary Kay. Surprise yourself. Not only others, but surprise yourself. I know you can do it. God bless you all. Have a great, great, great end of the year.